For 2 minutes.
I thank the chairman for yielding. I thank him for his leadership, and I ask unanimous consent to revise and extend.
Without objection, sir.
First of all, it's a pleasure to rise to support this bill, and let me say, specifically address the defense portion, which is indeed our primary constitutional responsibility, a strong national defense. First, I want to thank my ranking member, Pete Buskowski, for his help in crafting this bill. It was not an easy task, given the short deadlines. I think we've produced a bipartisan product that meets our national defense needs. Thank all the committee's members and our professional staff for their hard work. A few words about our allocation, which is a direct result of the decision we made in mid-December. The base allocation is $486.9 billion, which is $29 billion below the president's budget request and $25.7 billion below the bill we passed, the defense bill we passed in July. The overseas contingency allocation is $85.2 billion, which is $4.5 billion above the request. Even with the small increase in the overseas contingency allocation, which we essentially use for buyback readiness, the subcommittee's tasks were formidable. We cut $24.5 billion from the administration's budget request. I want to assure my colleagues that not many programs were left untouched. We did our best to protect quantities of critical major weapon systems and avoid significant disruption to vital programs. And importantly, we gave our military leaders much badly needed predictability about future expenditures and preserved jobs in our defense industrial base. And most importantly, too, we protected readiness. Our Constitution's first priority is to provide for a strong national defense. So if the Commander-in-Chief needs to call our troops, they'll be ready and prepared. I yield back the balance of my time.
The gentleman from Kentucky reserves and the gentlewoman